And now for today's Bible question. Today we've been learning about receiving spiritual light. We saw how the disciples wanted to learn how to pray and to conform their lives to the light that was given to them. We also learned how the Pharisees refused the light God had provided and asked to see a sign. Jesus rebuked their folly and warns of their condemnation. Someone might ask the question, what did Jesus mean by the light in us being darkness? In Luke chapter 11, verse 35, it says, "Therefore take heed that the light which is in you is not darkness." This statement seems rather confusing, for how can light be called darkness? We need to understand that Jesus is talking about spiritual light. Spiritual light is a revelation given to us by God. This comes to us through the Word of God and the Holy Spirit helping us to understand and see the truth. The seeing is what should happen if we have good spiritual eyes. We can have good spiritual eyes when we are ready to hear God speak and are willing to accept and obey what we learn from God. For instance, if a person did not understand that God desires them not to use the Lord's name in vain, and then they read their Bible and hear God say, "You shall not use the Lord's name in vain," and they are convinced about it and therefore stop committing this sin, then they have received spiritual light and accepted it by being obedient. While Jesus performed so many miracles for others to see, it was as though a great light was shining for everyone to see. If anyone had good spiritual eyes, they would see and understand that Jesus was sent from God, and they would gladly follow him, learn from him, and obey him. But if their eyes were damaged, so that the light could not enter into them, then they would be full of darkness. If we think of spiritual light as God's revelation and understanding of the mind of God, then we can appreciate that those who refuse to accept Jesus as God's Messiah were refusing a clear revelation from God. They did have some revelation from Scripture, but had misunderstood it and added it to their own ideas, which were not from God at all, but from their own evil desires. Thus, the spiritual light inside of them was not God's light, but their own folly, which they believed was God's truth, but was just their own darkness. Here, darkness needs to be understood as man's false understandings and his false religious ideas. So when Jesus says the light in them is darkness, what he meant was that the false religious ideas that were guiding some people were not God's light, as they might have thought, but was man's light, which is not light at all, but darkness. It might seem a bit confusing to understand, but perhaps another illustration can help us to get the point. Imagine if I thought it was okay to take some herbal medicine to cure me of a sickness. But when I went to the doctor, he told me that the herbal medicine was not good for me and that I should take the medicine that he prescribed. Now, I could choose to follow the doctor's advice because he is a trained professional, or I could decide to go with the herbal medicine in hopes that it will help me. If I refuse to listen to the doctor who knows best what medicine I need, then I am refusing to accept the doctor as a qualified professional. I'm saying that all of his learning and training are not as important to me as my understanding and beliefs about herbal remedies. My pride has blinded me to the truth, and darkness is ruling inside of me. However, if I accept the doctor is much wiser and more knowledgeable about my condition, and trust his advice and follow it, then I am allowing his knowledge to enter in and be my guide. I have accepted the light of his knowledge, and I am made well through his help. So Jesus is trying to teach us that we need to acknowledge that he is much wiser and more knowledgeable than we are, and we can trust in his guidance. We have plenty of evidence to assure us that he is qualified to govern our lives and make us God's children because of all his good works and miracles. If we accept the light that God has given to us through Jesus, then we shall be made well, and God's light will be in us. I do hope that you are allowing the light of the gospel to penetrate into your heart, and that you have received Jesus by faith. Don't allow darkness to rule in your life, but commit your life to Jesus and receive God's light. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 6.